These are the burgers we made last night. They look good, right? The sizzle and the juiciness. It smells amazing.
Look at that.
That looks crazy good, you guys.
Looks really yummy.
But like most recipes on the internet, it's really easy to make a recipe look good in pictures and video, but it's tough to actually get it to taste good.
What does it need?
Yes.
Whoa, good one.
Oh, I like it.
Okay. Flavor?
We baked this burger for 15 minutes. It might have been better baking it for 7. It's also easy to make it look like it worked. This burger might fall apart when you hold it. You would never know. And it's easy to make it look easy. I can make a recipe that took us 2 hours look like you can do it in 2 minutes. But because good enough is good enough, for most recipe creators, it's not worth going back and making it easier, better, more likely to work and for you to be successful. Because secret number 2, if it doesn't work for you, someone that's trying their recipe, it's your fault. By nature, you're gonna say, oh, I messed it up. I didn't get it right. Didn't work for me. So there's a few ways to figure out if a recipe is actually worth it, worth making, worth using. First of all, if the recipe was shared with you, not on Facebook or Instagram or another social media, if it was sent to you by text or email, with a link, that's someone who's tried it and is personally recommending it to you, it's probably worth making. It's a good sign if others are looking for it. So if you stumble across a recipe, go to Google and type in the name of that person's website and see if Google suggests that particular recipe. For example, if you go to Life is No Yolk, it's gonna say, ooh, do you want their queso recipe? Google knows what's actually good. A recipe might be worth making if it's a staple. If the person who made it says it's a regular in their house, there's a good chance it's worth making. But if they don't say that, if you found the recipe on a tools website, like if you went to the Vitamix website, a KitchenAid website, the Instapot website, they have recipes for their tool. Those recipes have been tested and vetted by their kitchen, by their marketing department, and they want you to be successful. If it came from there, it's probably good. If you got the recipe out of a hardcover book, it's probably worth making. Those recipes go through extensive testing before they're put out by a big publishing house. And bonus, if it came from a crowdsourced recipe book, like this one, 100 Whole Food Recipes from our fans and family. So they went to say like, all right, what's your favorite recipe, one that you actually make in your home? Give us that one. Because if a food blogger has 100 recipes on their site, they probably make 3 to 5 of them on the regular, and the rest are just kind of filler. A recipe might be worth making if there are lots of comments on it, especially polarizing comments. If people say, I love it, I love this recipe so much, I love it, even for people who don't adhere to this specific diet. It's a gluten-free recipe, and my non-gluten-free spouse really enjoyed it. That's a really good sign. On the other end, if there are people saying they hated it, there's a good chance that maybe the recipe was too flavorful for them. The ratings don't mean much, but the quantity of comments, and if you look at the quality of a few of them, that's a good sign. And the last one, if a recipe is totally unencumbered, recipes that are sponsored by companies, same thing. Whoever was getting paid to make this recipe whipped it up, did it, and said good enough is good enough, and shipped it out. So be wary of a recipe creator overselling for a particular brand. Guys, next video from us is those burgers. We're gonna try and remake them tonight, and hopefully they'll have some flavor, and they'll be a little bit easier than the first time we made them. And guys, subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Hit that bell to get notified, and if you appreciate videos like this, hit that thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.
I mean, it was good, I'm like eating it, but not the best burger I've ever had.